Would you like to learn about the process for designing a cloud architecture or enterprise architecture? If so, this video is for you. This video is the next part of a series on the cloud architecture and enterprise architecture process. In this video, we will introduce the process for developing a technology architecture. Specifically, we will be discussing Phase D, of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework. Phase D is all about developing the technology architecture. At GoCloud Careers, we are a member of the Open Group and leverage the TOGAF framework as it provides a structured and repeatable approach to designing cloud and enterprise architectures that drive digital transformation. We like the TOGAF framework as it's an industry standard, which is used by major players in the enterprise architecture space like IBM, Microsoft, Dell, Intel, VMware, Accenture, Deloitte, Cognizant, Capgemini, SAP, and many other elite technology organizations. After developing the data architecture, the next phase of the enterprise architecture process really begins with developing the technology architecture. If you haven't seen the video on developing an architecture vision, developing the business architecture, or developing the data architecture, you can find those videos in the description of this video. Developing the technology architecture is Phase D of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture process. In today's world, technology is critical to modern business. Businesses that have the best technology architectures will have a significant competitive advantage. Businesses who lack strong technology capabilities will struggle to thrive and may find themselves out of business. But the technology architecture is not about the best technology. I want to say it again. The technology architecture is not about the best technology. It's about the technology that best meets the needs of the business. That's why long before we think about the technology, we must develop the architecture vision and the business architecture. So what is the technology architecture? Technology architecture is the blueprint for the hardware, software, and network infrastructure that supports the business applications and business processes. Its main purpose is to ensure that all parts of the organization's technology environment are integrated, scalable, reliable, and efficient. What components go into the technology architecture? Computing. That means servers, containers, and functions as a service. It means storage, such as block storage, file storage, and object storage. It includes networking, things like routers and switches. Applications, whether they be HR applications, finance applications, custom applications, ERP systems, CRM systems, and all of the applications that support the business. It includes security systems such as firewalls, intrusion detection, intrusion prevention systems, IAM systems, endpoint protection, and other types of security environments. It includes artificial intelligence and automation, and it includes communications and collaboration platforms like phone systems, video conferencing systems, and unified communications. And of course, any and all other technologies that supports the needs of the business. Note, these are the same systems regardless of whether they are housed in the data center, a private cloud, a public cloud, a hybrid cloud, a multi-cloud, or even a super cloud environment. Now that we have defined the technology architecture, we must first baseline the current technology architecture. What is the current technology architecture? How is the current technology architecture working? What's wrong with the current technology architecture? And what's right with the current technology architecture? And how is the current technology architecture supporting the enterprise's needs? Next, we need to develop the future technology architecture. This is the architecture that's going to support the new business architecture, meaning the way we want the business to operate in the future. See, the future technology architecture is based upon the architecture vision, the new target business architecture, and the data architecture. What's key to remember is designing a technology architecture is the following. Organizations don't invest in technology because they like it. They invest in technology to enhance business performance. So every part of the technology architecture must address a business need or goal. Now that we've done the baseline technology architecture and the future technology architecture, we need to perform a gap analysis. Specifically, we need to find the difference between the current technology architecture and the future or target technology architecture. We need to evaluate all the options to go from the current technology environment to the future technology environment. This evaluation includes looking at all the trade-offs and architectural choices. Remember, nearly every architectural decision will have an impact on the business, and we need to pick the technology options that are best for the business, not for technology's sake, but for the business. We will then need to confirm the plan to go from the current technology architecture to the future technology architecture will support all business requirements and goals. Next, we need to conduct a formal stakeholder review of the new technology architecture. Stakeholders are individuals who have a vested interest in the enterprise, its success, and its decision making. We then need to confirm that the technology architecture satisfies all stakeholder requirements. Remember that all architectural choices may help one part of the organization place additional burdens on another part of the organization. This means we will likely have to do some negotiation between stakeholders to get to the ultimate solution. Next, we need to get buy-in from the stakeholders so they will support the changes when they're implemented later. Lastly, we need to finalize the technology architecture. We need to fully document the technology architecture, and we need to document each building block of the technology architecture. We then need to store these documents or work products in the architecture repository. Remember, the architecture repository is where all critical architecture documents are stored. Now you know phase D of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework, developing the technology architecture. Of course, this is a high-level overview. If you'd like to have a deeper understanding of this, make sure to look at our training content. The link is in the description below. To learn how to get your first cloud architect job, please download the ebook. The link is in the description below. Also, please join us on the completely free webinar on how to become the ultimate cloud architect. The link for that is in the description below. Please like this video and subscribe to our channel, and be sure to hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you with your cloud computing or enterprise architecture career. I look forward to seeing you in a new video. Take care.